we put a lot of time and hard work into these tricks throughout our careers. And back then, tricks that we discovered and we invented was basically our calling card. And especially for those who didn't have a pro model yet. Yep, those were our signature moves, and they were respected. And that's how we did things back then. And that should never be forgotten. It should never be rejected or changed or any of that. So after about 2 years of doing this trick behind me, I decided to revisit it. After doing more research, further research on this trick, the very first H Street video, and there's one guy, his name was Ben Job. I don't know if he's still around today, if he's still skating or not, but he's the only one that did this trick. His variation was different than mine, as I discovered when Tony Magnuson pointed that out to me. Upon more careful observation, and I was looking at frame by frame, I did notice he did in fact steps off the board, boom, the board comes up, straight up, and his knee comes up, hits it, and it rotates 180 degrees, and then he lands on it like that. That's the same variation that Jason Park was demonstrating after he had watched a video of Chris Haslam doing it. So after I did further research beyond watching the 1988 Shackle Me Not 8th Street video with Ben Job, a couple years later I came across a video, late 1980s pro skater who I didn't know at the time until recently in the past couple years. He had posted a video that I saw maybe a couple months ago where he's doing just a regular pressure flip, no comply pressure flip, but it flips in the same way that my variation does, but he remains looking forward while keeping his eyes focused straight down on the board. Each of those variations are pretty difficult to master, and it took me probably about a good year or two, maybe three, before I could just do it without even any thought. So the variation that I discovered and invented sometime between December of 1988 and February of 1989.
This is gonna show proof that I started to work on my trick that I invented, the trim flip that I call it now. At the time it was called Frontside 180 no comply pressure flip to be exact. So here he goes. There I am. There you see me trying it right there.
I had been watching Ray Barbie on the 1988 public domain where he's doing his full 360 degree no complies. And I was trying to do that in my parents' garage. And as I was doing that, I was just popping it really high, and then as I was trying to turn a 360 degrees with the board really fast, the board just over rotated and flipping right as I was in midair. And I was like super excited and stoked for that, because right then and there I was like, holy crap, I think I just came up with a new variation of the no comply. And I just completely forgot about doing the 360 no comply, and I worked on the flipping method, which I didn't have a name for it at the time. I was just so excited. I wanted to learn this trick and get it down good. It took me probably a good couple of days until I got it.
And this is the first time I actually was pretty confident enough that I could do it in front of an audience. And I did pull it once right there. I started to lean a little too far forward, and I I braced myself.
We didn't have a name for the variation that I came up with until maybe a few years later. One of my good friends at the time, Jeff Everett, he was telling me,
do a pressure flip, no compliance, good stance.
So I was like, oh, okay. I think I know what he's talking about. But even then, back then, it didn't really sound quite right, but it was pretty close. So fast forward like 20, 30 years later, I was thought about it for a while and I was like, okay, so you're doing a frontside 180 no comply, but at the same time, you're flipping the board. So it's kind of like a kickflip, 180 kickflip, but it's not. It's more like a pressure flip, because if it was a kickflip, you'd be using your front foot. But if you're using your back foot, it's more like a pressure flip. And I'm using my back foot, and it's flipping off the outside of the board, okay? Other skaters who might have discovered this on their own without seeing any other past videos, they may have gotten really excited that thinking that this was their invention or idea, their puzzle trick, whatever they want to call it. I understand that. It's exciting when you discover something or you feel like you discovered it on your own, whether or not you've seen videos of other people doing that in the past. I have seen plenty of videos of Thandi Anderson doing a frontside 180 no comply pressure flip, but he's doing opposite direction because, you know, he's goofy foot. Frontside 180 no comply pressure flip, that's a really long name, so I had to come up with an official name for this only after I had done my thorough research on this and discovered that I was pretty much the first to invent this variation. Originally I was gonna call it the Trimble flip, but that didn't really roll off the tongue so well, so then I just shortened it to trim flip, kind of like half cab. And it's really important for, you know, skaters like me who grew up skating and didn't receive as much opportunities as other pro skaters out there because of how the economy was and there wasn't a whole lot of money in skateboarding. So basically our signature move that we discovered and came up with was our calling card, and that was extra important to us, and that's something to have a lot of pride in. So there you have it. The frontside 180 no comply pressure flip, aka the trim flip. You know, it's perfectly fine for an athlete and a skateboarder to name their own tricks. It's no different than an artist signing their own work. It's their trademark and their stamp of approval.